How's it going, guys? Yeah, I'm mainly making this video tonight because I got a package from a good buddy of mine, Nick, also known as Motley Crue Forever One here on YouTube. So if you're not familiar with his channel, I'll leave a link so you can check it out. But he's got a really killer channel. He posts frequently, a lot more than I do. And he's got a really huge collection and it's really killer stuff. Mostly different types of black metal, but he is into a lot of old other stuff too, from old school thrash and heavy metal, just all different forms of metal really. But yeah, he's one of the first people I started talking to here on YouTube and kind of stayed in touch with. And I was commenting on one of his videos a few days ago and he told me he had a package coming my way. And the package came today, and actually this is my second time making this video, because the first one I kind of screwed it up halfway through, so I already opened the package, so I guess you guys don't have to watch me fiddle with the package for 2 minutes trying to open it. So I'll just show you what he sent me. So first off, I want to say thanks, Nick. I really appreciate this, man. It means a lot, and this is something that I was really looking forward to. And the fact that you knew that I was gonna end up wanting to get this and decided to buy it for me just means a lot, man. So I really appreciate that. So basically what he sent me is this record by Vindland, and this is called Haunter Sabe, and this is their official debut album that came out in 2016. So yeah, they released it on CD, and then they also released it on cassette. Then they finally just got around to issuing it on vinyl. And I think he had told me a while back that they're gonna be issuing it on vinyl, so I was really looking forward to this, because I like this album a lot. Definitely one of the best releases of 2016. He showed it in his video a few days ago, and that's when I commented on it, and he's like, hey, don't buy it yet because I got something coming your way. So I kind of spoiled the surprise for myself. But if you're not familiar with Vindland, they are a kind of like melodic black metal band from France, and they came out, I think, with like an EP in like 2009 or something, and then I don't know what happened, but they were on quite of a long hiatus, and they finally came back and released this album in 2016 as like their first full-length album. And man, what an album this is. It's freaking awesome. Even if you're not into black metal, I recommend checking this out and just at least giving it a chance, because it's kind of not as straightforward of black metal as you think. I think it's accessible, not in a in like a mainstream sounding way by any means, but I just mean that I think it's got kind of like a universal feeling to it when you're listening to it. All the song titles and lyrics, as far as I know, are in a language called Breton. I think it's some sort of native language that originated in like Great Britain or maybe even France, but I'm not really familiar with all the history of that stuff. All I know is it's really cool to finally have this album, and I knew that they're reissuing it or releasing it on vinyl eventually, and just found out about it the other day when Nick showed it. So yeah, it just comes on black vinyl. That's the label. And once again, Nick, thank you so much, man. Really happy to have this in my collection, and I think I'm gonna go spin this after I'm done with this video, because this album just doesn't get old. Alright, and then I'm actually going to show some CDs too that I got recently, mainly because I kind of neglect my CDs and I don't show them as often. But this first CD I want to show real quick, this is actually something else that Nick sent me a couple months ago. He had obtained an extra copy of this from the label, and he made a video and said, whoever wants it, just send me an email, and I happen to be the first one. So once again, thanks, Nick. I really appreciate it. And the band and CD, this is Soul Dissolution, and the album's called Stardust. And this is atmospheric black metal, I would call it. Or, yeah, I guess it's kind of hard to put an exact label on it. But I would call it atmospheric black metal. And as far as I know, this is their second album. They're based out of Belgium, and this also came out on Black Lion Records, which I think I failed to mention about the Vinland release, but they're actually also on Black Lion Records. Just a great label from what I've heard from them so far. They've got some killer releases on there. So yeah, this is just an all-around great album. My favorite song on this is the last one, Far Above the Boiling Sea of Life. Yeah, and surprisingly, this album's not too long for an atmospheric black metal album. I think it's under 40 minutes, so definitely worth checking out. I'll leave a link for this as well, so you guys can give it a listen if you'd like. All right, and then I got a few other CDs to show. This one I picked up at a show the other day. This is Flotsam and Jetsam with their most recent self-titled album that came out in 2016. And this is a really killer album. Especially if you like thrash, Flotsam and Jetsam, and you haven't checked this out, then definitely give it a listen. A few of the best tracks are probably Seventh Seal, Iron Maiden, and Life is a Mess. But just a kick-ass album. I think Eric's vocals are sounding better than ever. It's crazy how good he sounds live too. I mean, I think he sounds just as good, if not better, than he ever did. So same goes for this album too. So definitely check it out. You know, I don't really hear anybody talk about this album for some reason either, because it's probably one of the better modern thrash releases that's come out in the last few years. So. All right, next up, I've got Excel with The Joke's on You. It's their second full-length album, and this originally came out in 89. This is a reissue with like a bunch of bonus tracks, which is pretty cool. Also, the art's a little different. I think the original had like a white background, not this black background, but cool nonetheless. And I would say that I like the album Split Image a little more than this one, but this is still a really good album. A couple of my favorite songs are Seeing Insane and Blaze Some Hate. So yeah, just really good Venice-style crossover thrash from the 80s. And one of my favorites of the genre. All right, next up is a live album. This is Children of Bodom with Tokyo Warhearts. And this was recorded in 99 in Tokyo, right after Hatebreeder came out. So basically it's all tracks from the first two albums, which in my opinion are their best albums. And this is just a killer performance. I really love the artwork on this too. Just really good stuff. Definitely worth checking out if you like Children of Bodom. Alright, next up is a CD that I should have had in my collection a long time ago, but just got around to picking it up. And this is actually a recent Hammerheart reissue of Pestilence, Consuming Impulse. And yeah, what needs to be said about this album? It's just a classic old school death metal album. Definitely one of my favorites. And this reissue is pretty cool because the slipcase has got the alternate artwork that the label used without the band's permission. And then the CD has what was intended to be the artwork for the album. And it's basically just like a bunch of people eating each other. And I don't know, for some reason the label thought it was too extreme or something at the time, so they went ahead and used the other one without the band's permission, as far as I know. But I actually like this artwork a lot. I probably like it better than this one for some reason. I don't know. I think the color scheme on it is just a lot cooler. But yeah, great album. And actually, this reissue also comes with a bonus CD of a bunch of live tracks recorded in 88 and 89. So yeah, it's really cool to hear some of these songs live. And you know, Martin von Drunen's vocal performance is just killer. Oops. And last but not least, this is Gojira with L'Enfant Sauvage, however you pronounce that. But this is not their most recent album, but their second newest. This came out in 2012. And yeah, this is my favorite Gojira album, actually. Partly because it's the one that got me into Gojira when a friend gave me this album. But also because now that I'm more familiar with their material, it's kind of their best blend of like the heavier, like death metal-y kind of stuff and more progressive and like melodic elements that they have. I don't know, I think it's just like a really good balance between the two styles, if you want to call it that. But yeah, really great album. Just front to, or start to finish, it just kicks ass. Some of my favorite songs are gonna be Explosia, The Axe, and The Gift of Guilt. Yeah, I'll leave a link so you guys can check this out. Definitely worth checking it out. It's really a really good starting point to get into Gojira too. Way better than Magma, in my opinion, which, I don't know, I think Magma's okay, but nowhere is near as good as this album. So, once again, just my opinion. But yeah, anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this video, this update. Once again, thank you, Nick, man. I really appreciate it. That was super cool of you to send that that album to me. And yeah, I will talk to you guys later. Until next time.